Good morning all. You're all welcome to this segment, and what we're about to look at now, we're going to look at the twins and their temperaments. That is all we are looking at this morning. We're going to look at the temperament of twins, how twins behaves. We know that twins are two people. Some are identical and some are not identical. Some can be a boy and a boy, a girl and a girl, or otherwise a boy and a girl, in that order. But today we want to look at twins as a general subject matter, and then say that twins, as we earlier said in the mystery of twins, that they are two separate identities. They have their different temperaments. They are made up of the younger twin and the elder twin. Now we'll quickly look at the younger twin. The younger twin is the one that is that came out last. That's the younger twins, from their mother's womb. He or she is the one that came out last, and he or she always proves to be wiser and smarter than the elder twin. He or she has a very high temperament. The younger twins might be a sanguine or a choleric, or a combination of the sanguine and the choleric character or traits. Now we're going to look at the younger twin as a sanguine. He or she is a very free and playful person, but a very powerful orator, and can easily forget the past. He or she can easily forget the past, meaning that if anything has happened now, maybe between the both of them, he or she can easily forget about it and easily reconcile with his or her sister. They are jack of all trades. They are jack of all trades, and they can do everything. For example, if she's a girl, you see, she can plait hairs, can be good in plaiting of hairs, can be good at taking care of babies, keeping the house clean like that, doing other works at home. He or she can easily interact with people, relate with people, discuss issues and ideas with people. When a visitor comes in, or when they're supposed to confront people in a conversation, you see the elder twins will shrink back and the younger twin will come up to interact and then relate issues or matters with the people, converse with people. Those are the natures of the younger twin. As such, they are emotional, unstable, and always talk too much. Yes, that trait makes them unstable, emotional. They can quickly be angry, they can quickly be happy, quickly be excited, and so on. The next one, and they talk too much. They can talk too much. Yes, they can converse with people too much. They can easily talk and interact with people friendly, unlike the elder twin. Now we're looking at the younger twin again as a choleric. He or she is a very angry person. He or she can easily be provoked and we easily, he or she is very, very, they are very angry people. They can easily be angry, flare up, and they can easily engage into fighting. They can quickly fight with their twin brother or sister or other people because of their temperament. Very people. They become very arrogant, hardworking. The only thing you take from them is they are dutiful, very hardworking. They're using their hands to do things. Perfect. And they are self-sufficient. Because of that, because of their ability to do things with their hands, talk too much, and become they are powerful orators. They can take charge anywhere they are. They feel very wise and smart. Because of that, they are self-sufficient. They believe they don't want, they don't lack anything. They believe they are self-satisfied. They have all what they want. In the game, they are dominant. That makes them domineering over their brother or their sister, their twin brother or their twin sister. Because of these attributes in them, they are very hardworking, can easily do things with their hands, they can easily express themselves both outside and inside, and they can easily take charge of things. And then because of their angry nature that makes them flare up and become boisterous, they are domineering. They try to subdue their elder twin brother or twin sister. Again, they are decisive. Whatever they decide, any decision they have to take as two entities, their decisions supersedes most time. And again, they are self-employed. Like I told you earlier, they can easily do things with their hands. Like a girl can easily use her hand to plait, while the elder twin sister cannot, finds it very difficult to do that. They can easily go into bakings, using their hand to bake things, selling them. In fact, they are proactive. That's the nature of the younger twin. And again, they don't seek detail of anything. Because they are self-sufficient, they don't care to seek detail of whatever they are doing. They just do whatever they do, express the thinking, maybe the way they are doing it is the right way. That's the nature of the younger twin. Now, we look at them. The choleric twin is self-determined, very determined and very practical, with a strong heart. Yes, they are very practical with a strong heart, and whatever they want to do, they believe they can do it better. They are fearless and very bold for hot temper. Yes, the younger twin, any day, any time, he or she is very bold, very courageous, can withstand any personality at all, because they have that inherent nature in them to be fearless, to be bold, and then because of their hot temper, they don't fear anymore. Yes, they do not care the consequences to others. Whatever will happen, will happen. They don't care. They can easily pick up something to smile somebody, not caring the consequence.
even to their own twin, their own twin brother or twin sister. But at last, because they are emotionals, they are very emotionals, they will quickly go into crying and then begging. So they also have a revengeful spirit. If you do them anything, they must revenge. And if they have not revenge, they don't rest. They are dictators, gluttonous in nature, and as such, they easily grieve the Spirit of God. Yes. Because of this fragile nature, the younger twins, they easily grieve the Spirit of God, because the Spirit of God does not stay where there is strife all the time. And their nature makes them to always strike at any little provocation. Now, we want to look at them, the younger twin, the ones that combine the temperament of a sanguine and a choleric. The younger twin can combine these two temperaments that are listed above from birth. This combination is from birth. It's not the one that maybe they grew to copy. No, it's inherent in them right from birth. So with the underlisted temperament, the younger twin, like in the case of Jacob, that took dominion over
Quinto.
That dominated over his
seat.
In the case of Jacob, we saw that Jacob dominated over his elder twin brother in almost everything. So they are very good at creating a scene of quarrel. Yes, between these two people, at any slight mistake or provocation, they are very good at creating a scene for quarreling. Before you know, they have started quarreling. That's why you see, between, if you have twins in your house, you see that they like quarreling all the time. As I was still saying, that they are good at creating a scene for quarreling and fighting between the two of them. Yes, the younger twin is very good at creating a scene for quarrel at any slight provocation, any mistake done by the elder twin. The younger twin must try. There must be a fight. Then, I said the younger twin is good at creating a scene for quarreling at any slightest provocation. He or she must strike, because it is inherent in them, and they like fighting. Their only way of settlement is to fight over whatever he or she has felt that want to pose a threat to him or her. Now, we saw that in the case of Esau and Jacob, birthright must be given. In most cases, birthright must go for it. And they always demand equal respect, equal right an equal opportunity. And if the reverse should be the younger speak it. Yes, twins in your heart attest to that. They fight all the time. They fight all the time. As it is. Yes, will see time. And the younger twin, all twins. They are twins. For the opportunity or anything in share, so that's always amount to fighting. Okay, I've been talking all this while, and then right now we are moving to the next phase. An interviewer will have to take the stage.
Talking about the mystery of twins, as we all know, twins are like a mystery, because they are filled with many mysteries, even from the medical field down to the natural field. You can see that in those days, our forefathers never agreed to the fact that they were normal humans. So until the Scottish missionary Mary Slessor came and then changed the narrative, and they were not accepted as normal human beings in society. But despite that, there are some mysteries in them, especially when they are complete, like the both of them are extremely with each other, near each other. So we have been talking of the mystery of things for a couple of minutes now. I want to do some checks and balances on them. Who are these things? Can you explain to me who they are, who they really are?
Yes, thank you very much for that question. Twins are normal children born by parents, but in their case, they are two either identical or unidentical people that were born the same day by a single mother. The same day, the same, there's an interval of minutes or time.
Oh wow, that's one mystery. You guys should not forget that it's a mystery that two individuals can be born on the same day, then both of them look alike. Mostly they look alike, yes. Then see, just feel the difference in physique, but you see that they are still one. So she has said it that the twins are normal human beings like us, that they're just born into a family. They are not evil children. Can you tell us whether these children are seen as evil as our forefathers saw them years ago? Because we do have this narrative that twins are like evil children. They came from maybe any of those evil powers then that existed then. So can you just help us and elucidate that, whether these twins you're talking of, whether they are really evil children or not?
Wow, I appreciate that question. Thank you very much. Twins are not evil children. They are not evil tales. They are normal things that happens to nature. It's a God's gift. In fact, if you have twins in your family, you're a blessed family.
Wow,
you're a blessed man,
wow.
A blessed woman. In fact, they bring an unprecedented success and favor to such a family. Twins are normal children. They are, of course, is the relationship between a man and a woman that produces children, and that's exactly what produces twins too. But in this case, it's an additional blessing that God just give to you unmeritedly. You don't deserve it because it's a special blessing. They are normal human beings. In fact, we saw in the Bible days that God gave twins to Abraham as his grandsons, and they became the heir of the promise that God made to him.
Wow. So you're telling us that some of the Nigerian parents and other parents in the world, those people that don't have twins, they should better go and pray for twins, because with the way you're talking now, it's as if these twins are really a blessing from God.
Yeah, you're right.
Yes.
Every family needs to have a pair of twins.
Wow. Okay. You've heard it. If you don't have twins, better go and pray to God to give you twins. Now, let's go to the next one. You were talking on the types of twins. I don't really know how to identify these the types of twins, because many parents out there, they just see them as two children that were born at the same day. So I want you to clarify us on the types of twins and how to differentiate between them.
Yeah, we have just two types of twins, the identical and the non-identical twins. The identical twins, when we talk about them, they are either two girls or two boys, and sometimes they are either two boys or two girls, very identical in nature, in their face, in their physique, in their voice, in the way they do things, they are almost the same. That's one type of twins, and they are called the identical twins. Non-identical twins, they are sometimes a girl and a girl, a boy and a boy, or a girl and a boy, and they are not all that alike in their facial look, but you still see the similarities there, that they are twins.
Wow, applause to that answer. It's a brilliant answer, my dear. So let's move on. We can see earlier she said that twins are two separate entities, of which when they came to this world, you can see that they were born on the same day at the same place. Like they were not born in the morning, then some maybe in the night. They were born at the same day, just in a few difference of minutes or hours. That makes them twins. And you see the identical ones, nobody needs to tell that yes, this person, this boy and boy, or this girl and girl, or this girl and boy, they are really twins. So we can see that they were born two. But how come they turn out to be two separate entities? That's what I'm not that clear on. So you help clarify us how they became two separate entities.
Yes, thank you. Like you earlier said, they are two people born the same day. It can be the same day, different time, even it can be an interval of days, as the case, the medical case may be.
Okay.
Yes, so medical case can cause some complications that will lead to a delay in the delivery of the second one, but they are twins. When they come out, you still see they are twins, because they were conceived within an interval of 9 months in a single mother's womb.
So
they are two separate entities, yes, because even if they are twins, they have different thinking faculty, they have different brains. You know, it's our brain that helps us to think and articulate things.
Yeah.
So because of the brain is the engine that controls the human. So this engine, because it's different, they are not sharing the same brain, so they are different. That makes them two separate entities altogether, because at times they have to think differently, even if they are twins.
What the answer? That answer is very striking. It's very good. So let's move on to the next one. You can see that even if these people we're talking about, they are two separate entities. But as for many people that have them in their homes, they can tell the number of problems they give them every day at home, the number of things they do. Some of them, you see, they fight each other, they do things. You see, some of them have love, but the ones I've seen, they are really pathetic. But we can see that they have characteristics. Yes, they have characteristics. So can you just please mention some of those characteristics?
Yes,
of
the
twins,
characteristics of
as
twins.
Two separate entities.
Is that we have love.
Wow.
They love themselves. You can't offend one and go free. Because of the love in between them, if one is even sick, the other will be sick also.
Wow.
They have love, they have unity. No matter how they fight, they are united. They are soul and body, they are united. You cannot separate them. And then they have forgiveness. As they fight, the next moment, they are forgiving themselves. Those are, and they can easily give to one another. They give. They share things in common. So those are the characteristics of twins and so many more.
Wow, I can just pick that first one, that love they have for each other. If you like want to separate them from each other, you see that it will be a very, very big tug of war between the family, because the other one you're taking away may not agree to go. And also the other one that